Hey, so I'd like to make a quick video to explain what process substitution is for in shell scripting, because it's a handy feature that is a bit obscure but quite useful. So basically, it's a way to create a temporary file and put the output of a command in that temporary file and then give that temporary file as an argument of another command, but I will show an example and it will be much easier. So the syntax for this is you do a command like this. For example, let's say I want to diff between my host name and let's say my shells, and that doesn't make any sense, but whatever. And I have two files, but what I can do is also do this syntax where you have lower than opening a parenthesis and then a command in it. And for example, let's say I want to diff between host name and ls. And here you can see that it will take the output of this command and give it as a file to diff. And yeah, this is especially handy for me when I want to know the diff between two servers, where I do like something like diff and then sh to server A, and then you can cat some file on it and then do here sh server B and then cat some other file. And then it would like cat the server on server A, cat the server on server B, and then do the diff and stuff like that. There is a few caveats with that feature is that it's shell specific, so you can do it in bash, you can do it in zsh, and you can do it in the fish shell, but you cannot do it in a POSIX compliant shell like dash. It also exists in the input version, so you can do echo, let's say cat, let's say hosts, and then no shells, and then let's pass that to t. If you don't know what t does, it will take the standard input and then you precise a file as the first argument, and then it will output the output it received and also create a file foo that contains the same output. And so here you can do shell substitution but in the other direction. So instead of taking the output of a file and taking it and putting it in a temporary file, you can like put use stdin instead of stdout. So here I want to like output the content of the file and also the number of line of the file, and you can see that it outputted the content of the file and then the number of line here. And if the way you do that in the fish shell, so here I am in the fish shell, is pretty similar. You just do diff, and then here you have parentheses and then a command, and then you pipe that to p sub, and that will do the same result as in bash. Let's say let's see. Do you have Nginx? Yes. P sub, and you can see that it's the same thing but in the fish shell. Yeah, that's pretty much it. I just want to show a very quick example of what it would look like if we didn't use this. So I have a little script that I prepared here. So you can see I use this command mktemp, which will just create a temporary file. Then you execute the command and put it in the file, and then you do diff on that temporary file. And let's just echo f here, and then cat the content of f to explain it better. And then process sub, And then you can see that it created a temporary file. And here is the content of that temporary file. And here it executed the diff. So, yeah, it's a bit more verbose. You can get away with it, but it's quite. Process substitution is still quite handy if sometimes. So, yeah, that's it. See you.